بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ولي الصالحين، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، الحمد لله. We continue with the Lamia, the lines of poetry that end in Lam, all about the belief of Ahlul Sunnah and the methodology of Ahlul Sunnah. And it summarized the belief of Ahlul Sunnah by Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, one of the great scholars who died in the year 728 Hijriyah. And if one were to just look at his students, then he would know, or he would see the caliber, the great knowledge or vast knowledge of this alim, who wrote many of Ahlul Sunnah. And he left fatawa, majmu' fatawa, over 30 volumes. He wrote books in Aqidah, he wrote books refuting various groups, such as the Rafida, Shia, and the Sufis, who innovated and fell into shirk. And he clarified the correct belief, the Aqidah of Ahlul Sunnah, in how to believe correctly in Allah's beautiful names and attributes. And we have reached the line where Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he mentions about the believers seeing their Lord on the Day of Judgment. وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ يَرَوْنَ حَقًّا رَبَّهُمْ وَإِلَى السَّمَاءِ بِغَيْرِ كَيْفٍ يَنْزِلُ. The believers, the mu'minun, the believers, they will see their Lord حَقًّا, يعني in the real. We don't know how, but they will see their Lord. And this is backed up by the Quran, Sunnah, and in the understanding of the pious predecessors. وَإِلَى السَّمَاءِ بِغَيْرِ كَيْفٍ يَنْزِلُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends likewise to the lowest heavens in a way which befits His majesty. Here He said, بِغَيْرِ كَيْفٍ, without how. And this, Shaykh Sa'd al-Fawzan and Shaykh Ubayd al-Jabri and others call, without knowing how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends. But there is a kayfiyya that belongs to Allah that He knows, that is befitting for Him. But we don't know how, because our mind and our aql is limited. We don't follow the deen based upon our aql. We follow the deen based upon what Allah told us and what the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam conveyed. So we cannot picture and start delving into that. Don't enter into that which you have no knowledge. Inna sam'a wal basara wal fu'ada kullu ulahi kan anhu mas'ula. Don't go into that which you have no knowledge. Indeed, the hearing, the sight, the heart, all of that will be questioned. All of that one is responsible over. So don't enter into affairs which you have no knowledge. Don't speak about affairs which you have no knowledge. And when you speak about Allah, then it's serious. You have to speak about Allah only with knowledge. Only that which Allah has mentioned about Himself and what the Messenger has mentioned about Allah. The foundations are taken from the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, وَإِلَى السَّمَاءِ بِغَيْرِ كَيْفٍ يَنْزِلُ بِغَيْرِ كَيْفٍ نَعْلَمُهُ. Without a how that we know. يعني we don't know how. Nor do we liken Allah to His creation in Him descending to the lowest heavens. And He is still above the arsh in a way which befits His majesty. Even though His knowledge is vast and it is essence and self. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about Himself, Ar-Rahmanu ala al-arsh istawa. So let's look at the verses in the Quran. There are four verses in the Quran which actually mention the details of this. And they are the Surat Al-Qiyamah, verse 22-23. وجوههم يومئذ ناظرة إلى ربها ناظرة. On that day, faces will be illuminated and bright, looking. The second verse, لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا الْحُسْنَ وَزِيَادَةً. For those who do good, they will have al-husna. And if you look at the tafsir of Ibn Kathir and other mufassirin, and Ibn Kathir is from the students of Ibn Taymiyyah, and they explain that al-husna is paradise from the statements of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum. Waziyada is that extra. They will have something extra. What is extra than paradise? What is more than paradise? That will follow, inshallah. That verse is in Surah Yunus, verse 26. And likewise in Surah Al-Mutaffifin, verse 15. Kalla innahum an rabbihim yawma idhin lamahjubun. Rather, nay, of a surety, they will be, meaning the disbelievers, will be withheld from seeing Allah with a veil or barrier. They will not be able to see Allah. The believers will see Allah, but the disbelievers will not. And likewise, Allah mentioned about the believers will be given paradise. وَأُزْلِفَتِ الْجَنَّةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ غَيْرَ بَعِيدٍ هَذَا مَا تُوَعَدُونَ لِكُلِّ أَوَّابٍ حَفِيظٍ مَنْ خَشِيَ الرَّحْمَنَ بِالْغَيْبِ وَجَاءَ بِقَلْبٍ مُنِيبٍ أُدْخُلُوهَا بِسَلَامٍ. Enter paradise with security. أُدْخُلُوهَا بِسَلَامٍ. ذَلِكَ يَوْمُ الْخُلُودِ. That is the day which will be, inshallah, for their believers forever in paradise. That would be the beginning of paradise. لَهُمْ مَا يَشَاءُنَ فِيهَا وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ. They will have anything that they ask in there of good, and they will have that which is extra. And that which is extra, you'll spend the hadith, which will come to. And there are many narrations regarding this. The first of them is in the hadith of Sahih Muslim and in Sunnah Tirmidhi, and likewise in Ibn Majah, from the narration of Suhayb radiallahu anhu, that the message al-jannah al-jannah, yani when the people of paradise enter paradise, إِذَا دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ أَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ يَقُولُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. Allah will address them and say to them, تُرِيدُونَ شَيْئًا أَزِيدُكُمْ. Do you want something extra that I will give you? SubhanAllah, this is the same word in his use, أَزِيدُكُمْ. You have the verse mentions, وَلَدَيْنَا مَزِيدٌ, and we'll give you something extra. Then this hadith in Sahih Muslim is authentic. It's sahih. And he says, well, do you want that which I can give you? Do you want anything extra to give you? فيقولون. So the people who are in paradise will say, أَلَمْ تُبَيِّضْ وُجُوهَنَا. Didn't you already brighten our faces? أَلَمْ تُدْخِلْنَا الْجَنَّةِ. Didn't you already enter us into paradise? وَتُنْجِينَ مِنَ النَّارِ. And you've saved us from the hellfire. قَالَ فَيَكْشِفُ الْحِجَابِ. So Allah removed the hijab, the veil. And they would not have been given anything more beloved to them than seeing their Lord. Then it was recited, لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا الْحُسْنَى وَزِيَادَةً. For those who do good, they will have paradise and that which is extra. And that which is extra. No. And there are many narrations. In fact, Yahya ibn Ma'in from the scholars of Hadith, he said, عندي في الرؤية كلها صحاح. All of these narrations are from the authentic narrations. Who said this? Yahya ibn Ma'in from the scholars of Hadith. He has 17 authentic narrations, all of them about seeing Allah. And from those who narrated about the ru'ya are the Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum, of course. They're the ones who narrated. From them is Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radhiyallahu anhu, and Anas bin Malik radhiyallahu anhu, and Jabir ibn Abdullah radhiyallahu anhum. I'm going to mention all of them, then we say, may Allah be pleased with them all. Hudhayfah ibn al-Yaman, وزيد بن ثابت وصهيب وعبادة ابن صامت وابن عباس وابن عمر وابن مسعود ولقيط ابن عامر وأبي رزين وعلي بن أبي طالب وعدي ابن حاتم وعمار بن ياسر وفضال بن عبيد وأبي سعيد الخدري وأبي هريرة رضي الله عنهم أجمعين. صحابة. All of them narrating from the hadith of Ru'ya. So how are we going to reject the hadith of Ru'ya and all of these narrations? Alhamdulillah. All of them supporting each other. Authentic narrations. And we already read the hadith in Sahih Muslim, which is also reported in Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah. And likewise in Bukhari and Muslim. From the hadith of Abi Hurairah radiallahu anha, radiallahu anhu, he said that the people will say, Ya Rasulullah, will say, well, we'll see, O Messenger of Allah, Allah on the Day of Judgment. فَقَالَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ هَلْ تُدَارُونَ فِي رُؤْيَةِ الْقَمَرِ لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. Do you have a problem in seeing the full moon on the night of Badr, meaning the middle of the month, because the full moon comes out in the middle of the month, 13, 14, 15. It's called this Ayyam al-Bidh, 13, 14, 15. That's when the full moon. قَالَ فَإِنَّكُمْ تَرَوْنَهُ كَذَلِكَ. So just as you don't have a problem in crowding yourself, in having difficulty in seeing your Lord on the night of Badr when the moon is full, likewise you will not have any difficulty in seeing Allah. You don't crowd each other to see the moon. So likewise you will not crowd each other, you will not find difficulty in seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Day of Judgment in a way which befits His Majesty. That hadith is Sahih Bukhari and Muslim. And likewise the hadith of which mentioned all 17 narrations, but we mentioned a few of them. Hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. Jarir ibn Abdullah al-Bajali, the famous narration. He said, we were sitting in the company of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we were looking at the moon on the night of the 14th night, which is from the Ayyam al-Bidh, from the nights of al-Badr. Yani the moon is a full moon. And the Messenger, you will see your Lord, yani, with sight, with your sight, you will see him. كما ترون هذا لا تضارون في رؤيته. You will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your eyes, with yani, with sights, just as you see this moon with your eyes, and you don't crowd each other or have difficulty in seeing it. فإن استطعتم أن لا تغلبوا على الصلاة قبل طلوع الشمس وقبل الغروب. So if you're able one time, then do that. And that is the prayer before sunrise, meaning Fajr, and the prayer before Maghrib, meaning Asr. Now that hadith, as we said, is in Bukhari and Muslim. Now, and that is an encouragement, not an encouragement, it's showing you the importance of praying the Asr and the Maghrib on time, Asr and the Fajr on time. Now, before mentioned, there are different narrations. Some of them mention tudamun, hal tudamuna fi ru'yati, hal tudamuna fi ru'yati. Yani, do you have any difficulty, any mashaqqa in seeing your Lord? And the other narrations mentions tudamuna, which is with the shadda on the mim and the fatha on the ta. Means crowd? Do you crowd each other when you see the moon? No, you don't. So you would not crowd each other. So the one without the shadda on the mim and the dhamma on the ta, it means it refers to mashaqqa, refers to difficulty. The narration which mentions with the tudah moon, it is with means mashaqqa, and the narration which mentions tadah moon is means crowdedness. So, in order to see your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Day of Judgment, what's important is we believe in this great aqidah point, and that is that believers will see Allah, because there were a group of people who denied this, who denied that Allah will be seen on the Day of Judgment. The Mu'tazila denied that. The Jahmiyyah denied that. The Jahmiyyah, group of people who denied Allah's names and attributes outright, and some scholars Muslims. Why they denied what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned about himself in the Quran outrightly. And they denied not only his names, they denied his attributes as well. As for the Mu'tazila, they affirmed his names, but without meaning. And they denied his attributes. And so from his attributes is Allah is above the arsh, for example. Allah descends. The believers will see Allah because they're using their aql against the text. They're using the intellect opposing the texts. One of the great scholars of hadith, Nu'aym ibn Hammad, rahimahullah. Nu'aym ibn Hammad, rahimahullah. He said, Sa'altu Abdullah ibn Mubarak. We're talking about 2nd century here, Hijriyah. In the 2nd century. He says, I asked Abdullah ibn Mubarak. I asked Abdullah ibn Mubarak, another scholar of hadith from the pious predecessors. I asked him about seeing Allah on the Day of Judgment. And Abdullah ibn Mubarak, rahimullah, he replied by saying, ما حجب الله تعالى عنه أحدا إلا عذبه ثم قرأ كلا إنهم عن ربهم يومئذ لمحجوبون ثم إنهم لصالوا الجحيم ثم يقال هذا الذي كنتم به تكذبون. So Abdullah, that those who have been withheld from seeing their Lord, يعني they are the ones who will be punished. So no one who has been refused from seeing their Lord, except that they will be punished. And then he recited the verse, كَلَّا إِنَّهُمْ عَنْ رَبِّهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَمَحْجُوبُونَ. Rather, nay, of a surety, they will be withheld from seeing their Lord with a barrier. They will not be withheld. They will not be able to see him because the صَالُ الْجَحِيمِ. Then they will be punished in the hellfire. ثم يقال هذا الذي كنتم به تكذبون. And then it will be said to them, this is what you used to deny. This is what you used to deny. نسأل الله السلامة. No. And it was said, قال عباد بن عوام قدم علينا الشريك the قاضي from the first three generations of the Muslims. It was said to him, Naam, and he's a Qadi, a great Qadi, great judge, he was known from the scholars. قال عباد ابن عوام قدم علينا شريك ابن عبد الله منذ 50 سنة فقلت له يا أبا عبد الله. So عباد ابن عوام is saying that شريك came upon us before 50 years. His quote is mentioning this was asked, Ya Aba Abdullah, by his kunya. So, O Shariq, Inna indana qawman min al-Mu'tazila. We have a people from the Mu'tazila. Yunkiruna hadi al-ahadith. They deny these narrations. The narrations, which are about the affairs of the unseen, no doubt. But these are in the Quran. These are in the Sunnah. Clearly. How are you going to reject something that is in the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? So, he said to him, there are people who deny this. And then ينزل إلى السماء الدنيا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends to the lowest heavens in the last third part of the night. وَإِنَّ أَهْلَ الْجَنَّةِ يَرَوْنَ رَبَّهُمْ. And the people of paradise, they will see their Lord. فَحَدَّثَنِي يعني ابن مبارك بنحو عشرة أحاديث في هذا. So Shariq the Qadi said, indeed Abdullah Mubarak narrated to me narrate a hadith regarding this. Yani regarding he's asking of me that I may give him. Who is there that is seeking forgiveness of me that I may forgive him? So he narrated that narration and narrated the other narrations about the unseen matters that are going to happen in the hereafter. From that is the believers will see their Lord. And then Shariq the Qadi, he added, Amma nahnu. فقد أخذنا ديننا هذا عن التابعين. As for us, we have taken our deen from the tabi'in. والتابعون أخذوه عن أصحاب رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the tabi'un, who were the successors, they took these narrations and their deen from the companions of the messengers صلى الله عليه وسلم. فهم عمن أخذوا. So whom did these deniers of Allah's attributes, whom did they take their deen from? Whom did they take their deen? Ibn Abi Dunya fi Sifat al-Jannah. No. So whom did they take their deen from? And we say that to all of the groups today. Whom did they take their deen from? As for us, we take our deen from the tabi'in, the successors, and from the sahaba. And whom did they take their deen from? All of these newly invented groups that, whom did they take their deen from? If they quote you a hadith, we want to hear the understanding of sahaba of that hadith, not yours, not mine. If they quote you a verse, we want to hear the understanding of the sahaba of that verse, not yours, not mine. We want to hear the sahaba radhiyallahu anhu's name being mentioned. This is their understanding. This is their manhaj. This is their aqeedah. It's not a game. This is the deen of Allah. So many years, and if you want to become a doctor, you study for so many years. You want to go to any, you wouldn't go to a plumber if you need an operation. Would you go to a plumber if you have something wrong with your urinary tract? You wouldn't go to a plumber, you go to a doctor. You specialize in that area. So, how is it when it comes to the deen, you take your deen from anyone and everyone? No, you have to be careful. As for us, Shariq the Qadi, as for us, we take about whom did they take their deen from? So everything is documented, alhamdulillah. Nothing is hidden. Imam Ahmad rahimullah, the scholar who died 241 Hijriyah, the great scholar, he said, those who deny the ru'ya, those who deny these narrations about the believer seeing Allah, then he's a jahmi. Fahuwa jahmi. He is a Jahmi, meaning it is like the Jahmiya, because they deny that. And this is mentioned by Ibn al-. And also, it was said from the famous statements of Imam Ahmad rahimahullah regarding a person who denied that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seen in the hereafter. So he became angry, very angry, غضب غضبا شديدا. وقال من قال إن الله لا يرى في الآخرة فهو كافر أو قد كفر. And he said, whoever doesn't say that Allah will be seen on the day of judgment or in the hereafter, then he's a disbeliever or he has disbelieved. Upon him will be the anger of Allah and his curse. Whoever that person is, because he's denied a verse. أليس يقول الله عز وجل وجوههم يومئذ ناظرة إِلَى رَبِّهَا نَاظِرَةٌ. That their faces will be illuminated, bright, looking towards their Lord. And then Allah say, كَلَّا إِنَّهُمْ عَنْ رَبِّهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَمَحْجُوبُونَ. Rather, of a surety, nay, they will be withheld from seeing their Lord with the barrier or hijab, a veil. Rahimullah, from his statements, is he said, مَنْ كَذَبَ بِالرُّؤْيَةِ فَهُوَ زِنْدِيقٌ. Whoever denies the ru'ya, that the believers will see Allah, then he's a heretic. And also he said, نُؤْمِنُ بِهَا, we believe in it, أَيَّ الرُّؤْيَا وَأَحَدِيثَا, we believe in it and its narrations. وَنَعْلَمُ أَنَّهَا حَقٌّ, and we know that it is truth. فَنُؤْمِنُ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يُرَى, we believe that Allah will be seen. We don't know how, but we believe in Allah. We will see Allah on the day of judgment. We do not doubt that. وَلَا نَرْتَابَ, nor do we have any hesitance regarding that. And that is quoted by Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah in his Hadi al-Arwah, page 239. And likewise he said, مَنْ زَعَمَ أَنَ اللَّهَ لَا يُرَى فِي الْآخِرَةِ فَقَدْ كَفَرَ بِاللَّهِ وَكَذَّبَ بِالْقُرْآنِ. ورد على الله أمره. Whoever says that they will, that the believers will not see Allah on the day of judgment, then he has dismissed. And he's rejected what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded with. So this is some of the narrations that Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah mentioned himself in Bayan Talbis al-Jahmiyyah, volume 1, page 350. And Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah in his Hajj al-Arwah, as I said, 239. And other than that, from the many narrations that all talk about the ru'ya, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will descend in a way which befits His Majesty. And we had not mentioned all of the 17 narrations. We only mentioned about 3 or 4 for the time, because of the time. As for the descending, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends no doubt in the last third part of the night. And this is a good encouragement for each and every one of us, that in that time, it's good to supplicate to Allah. It's good to say istighfar. والمستغفرين. That last third part of the night, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هل من تائبين؟ هل من سائلين؟ Is there a one to repent? Is there one to ask? هل من داعين؟ Is there one to supplicate? Until Fajr. And the group of Mu'tazila also denied that, because they're using their aql. They're saying, but how? We don't use our aql to reject the text. There are two types of aql anyway. There is the sane intellect. Insane intellect. The person who's insane, or he doesn't use his aql correctly. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already affirmed this for himself, and the Messenger has affirmed that for Allah, then a sane intellect would tell you to accept it. Why? Because you've read the Quran and you've seen the authority of Allah, and you know that this is the truth. You know the Messenger of Allah is the last Messenger, and he came with truth, and he was a messenger to all of mankind. Of life that will be accepted by Allah, accept this Islam. You know all of that, and you accept it with your aql. So why can't you accept those narrations which are authentic from the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam about the unseen? It means that your aql is not sane. You are insane then to reject the narrations. This is not sanity. If you've believed all of that, you believed everything that Allah has said in the Quran, you believed everything that the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, then you came to this aspect of you, and your aql is limited. Which means there's something wrong. And our deen is not based upon aql, mere intellect. Our deen is based upon qala Allah, qala Rasulullah, qala Sahaba. This is what the deen is based upon. What Allah said, then the Messenger hasn't conveyed. And the Sahaba, what they united upon is deen. And they did not oppose this. They believed it. And this encourages us also to supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He's there to listen to us. All of Ibn Adam makes mistakes. All of the children of Adam make mistakes. And the best of those who make mistakes are those who repent to Him. كل ابن آدم خطاء وخير خطائين التوابون. And also, even if you look at the word descend, ينزلوا, the word descend even amongst the creation is different. The rain descends from the sky. It's not like, is it like prices when you go to the shops and the prices, they either go up or they go down. And likewise, you yourself, your heart, what you love and what you hate, that sometimes increases and sometimes decreases. And your own blood pressure, if you have high blood pressure, it goes down certain times and goes up certain times. So ascending and descending, these two words, and nuzul, and all of this, even in the Arabic language, even in the dunya affairs, there are so many variances regarding that. So if you accept that with the creation, how can you not accept that with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is descending is in a way which befits His Majesty. And we don't deny that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends. Rather, we affirm that for Allah. We don't liken it to creation. We don't say it's like this and it's like that. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likened creation to Him. لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. There was no one like unto Him. There's no one like unto Him. And He is all hearing and all seeing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. To Allah belongs thee. The best, the highest of example. You can't give example of creation about Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is higher than that. Whenever, as Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah said, كُلَّمَا خَطَرَ فِي بَالِكَ فَاللَّهُ لَيْسَ كَذَلِكَ. To image Allah, then Allah is not like that. Because you and me are limited. كُلَّمَا خَطَرَ فِي بَالِكَ فَاللَّهُ لَيْسَ كَذَلِكَ. Sheikh al-Banna, Sheikh Muhammad al-Banna, Allah irhamu. He used to always mention that narration from Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah. كُلَّمَا خَطَرَ فِي بَالِكَ فَاللَّهُ لَيْسَ كَذَلِكَ. يعني Allah عز وجل نعم is above all of creation, and He descends in a way which befits His Majesty. He has beautiful names and lofty attributes befitting His great Majesty. So these are just some of the narrations regarding the Nuzul. And inshallah, in the next class, we will look at the Mizan, the balance of the scales, which will be put out on the Day of Judgment to weigh three things. Your scrolls will be weighed. You will be weighed. Likewise, your deeds will be weighed. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our scrolls and of good deeds heavy on the scales on the Day of Judgment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept the little good that we put forward, make it sincerely for His sake. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us our shortcomings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who will. And in paradise, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to establish our prayers, especially that Asr and Fajr, without passing its time, because that is the narration which mentions that is a reason for you to see your Lord, inshallah. So long as He does, if one is able to guard these two prayers without them missing it, then do so. And these two prayers also, the of the morning, the angel of the night, they change shift in these times. Those who used to record in the morning will change with those who record in the evening of what you do and what you put forward. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our scales of good deeds heavy. Heavy. Because the ones whose scales of good deeds are heavy, then he will be in عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ وَمَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينَهُ فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ. Scales of good deeds are light, then his abode will be al-hawiya. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا هِيَ نَارٌ حَامِيَ. And what will convey to you what this hawiya is? Hawiya, which is called the consumer. So hellfire, which is called the consumer. Hawiya. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا هِيَ نَارٌ حَامِيَ. A fire which burns. May Allah protect us from that. May Allah protect us and our family. وَسُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ بِحَمْدِكَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ أَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ.